Facts First presents. Neighbor asks to hold baby, then father takes a close look at the photo and exposes the truth. Today, it seems as though the world is divided. Considering how far we've come as a country, this is kind of strange. It seems as though we've gone further back in time when it comes to race relations. There are always stories on the news about race-related crimes, and it's kind of nice when you hear a story like this one. I'll share the story in just a moment. First, though, click the like button, and that way others can know that you're watching the video. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Cody Shugart was raised by a single mother. While his mom did a great job, he was a boy and really kind of needed a father figure in his life. And that's where Mr. Chip came in. Mr. Chip's real name is Milton West. He lived next door to Cody while he was growing up. Cody always called him Mr. Chip. Mr. Chip was retired from Dow Chemical as an operator, and he knew that Cody's father was not in the picture, and from the time he was 2 years old, Mr. Chip was there for him. Cody says that Mr. Chip stepped in as a father figure for him. He taught him the importance of a good education and always made sure that Cody was keeping up with his studies. He taught Cody how to take care of a yard. Mr. Chip made sure that Cody understood that his mother was a saint for raising him on her own and that he should treat her that way. He says his mentor taught him many life lessons that helped him become a good son, a good man, a good husband, and eventually a good father. Cody says he will forever be grateful that Mr. Chip was part of his life. When Cody and his wife had a son, they named him Bob Wayne Shugart. Cody says that thanks to Mr. Chip's guidance, that he was ready to be a good father. When the couple brought their new baby to see Mr. Chip and his wife, Mr. Chip asked that Bob call him Pop. They decided that his wife Shirley also needed a nickname, so she chose Lolly. This way, when they were going to visit the home, they would tell Bob that they were going to visit Lolly Pop. Cody says that Lolly and Pop babysit Bob often and that they visit the couple for Sunday dinners whenever they can. When the couple talks about Bob, they refer to him as their grandson. Cody shared his story on Facebook, and he expressed his appreciation and love for his neighbor, Mr. Chip. And at the end of the post, he wrote, "Every day I read something negative and how race relations are worse than ever. I disagree, and I hope this is a positive, loving message to many people. This is just one story in little old Victoria, Texas. I'm sure there are millions of similar stories across the United States." Cody was expecting his story to be read by his friends and family members on Facebook. He never expected his story to go viral. When Cody posted the story with a photo of Mr. Chip and his son, people began sharing it, and soon people all over the country saw the post. In only a few days, the post was liked over 367,000 times, and it was shared over 122,000 times. Cody says he never expected his post to become so popular, but he was thrilled that it did. He says he wants people to believe and know that we can all come together regardless of our backgrounds, race, sexual orientation, or beliefs. He says that just because people are different, it doesn't mean that we can't get along. He says he learned about acceptance years ago, and he was taught that lesson by Mr. Chip. If his neighbor hadn't taken him under his wing when he was a young boy, he wouldn't be the man he is today. Maybe he'd be one of the people who can't accept those who are different. Cody's grateful that he had Mr. Chip in his life growing up. He's even more thankful that his son will also have Mr. Chip in the family as well. Subscribe for more.